virtually all the royal family out from a side gate of Buckingham Palace, there was this very curious sight of thousands of people lining one side of the street, and the royal family, as it were, lining the other side. Again, there was a ripple of applause when they came out, which died away very quickly for everyone to stand in silence, because it was only a minute or so later that the cortege came past. And then during the service, you had here such a large gathering of people, and it's very unusual, particularly in this country, I think, in the open air, in bright sunshine, for people to stand so quietly. And they did follow the service very intently, listening so carefully as it was relayed. A lot of people joined in the Lord's Prayer, and there was such crying during Elton John's scene as well, and applause again at the end of that. It was as if everyone was listening as an individual, yet taking part united together. Not in any way a matter of emotional hysteria, not in any, just very private grief, but everybody's standing close together. And now, some time after, as it were, the ceremony is all over, this place is again a focus of attention. People have been drawn here, and there are, of course, the tens of thousands of flowers which are still in front of the palace. It's a beautiful sight, and there are candles there and the messages, and there are a lot of people who've taken their time now to come to this very heart, this very centre of royal occasions, to look at it.
And now let's go around the country and hear what's been happening outside this city. We've heard a great deal from London this morning. Let's first of all go to Cardiff and join Sarah Edwards.
Thank you, David. Well, here in the capital city of Wales, in the small, it is rather small village of Llandaff with its village green, both inside and outside the great cathedral here, there have been extraordinarily moving scenes. We've had over 2,000 people here this morning. During the minute's silence, you could have heard a pin drop, I suppose, and I'm sure that would be the same for everywhere around the country. But there's really been a very special feeling here in Wales because it is the capital city. And she was, after all, much loved to everyone, but also very much the Princess of Wales, and felt very much to be the Princess of Wales by the people who come here today. People have come out from the cathedral. We've obviously had the simultaneous service from the Abbey. And they haven't really wanted to go straight away. They've stayed, they've been very emotional, they've wanted to speak, they've wanted to talk amongst each other. And here we are, still here, it's carded over, but we're here on the green, and I have with me some ladies who are in the cathedral. Carol, Valerie and Jennifer, what do you think of the service?
I thought it was very, very moving. Particularly the 1 minute silence. You really could not hear a thing.
It's so dignified. Mm. Very dignified.
The tribute from her brother, Spencer. That was the most moving thing.
Very emotional experience, yes, indeed, to be there. You were all inside the cathedral, and there were so many more outside, yes, following closely in absolute silence.
It was wonderful inside. It had a wonderful atmosphere with everybody so... I mean, it was very tearful. People were emotionally involved with it. It was incredible.
And it was exactly the same as, obviously, the Abbey service. But for one thing, we had the Welsh National Anthem.
Yes,
at the end.
I know it in Welsh, you see, even though I'm English.
I'm sorry, I don't. I must do it one day, I must learn.
Do you feel that in some sense it has helped you to be here today, to be with everybody else and to share your emotions?
Oh yes, yes. Definitely. When it happened, it was about 7:30 in the morning, a friend of mine rang and told me the news, and because I was still quite bleary-eyed, it didn't quite sink in. But I was on my own and the children were still in bed, and I just sat there devastated. I didn't know what to do. I didn't know whether to ring friends in case they thought I was being silly. So something like this, where we've all pulled together and we've all shared this really deep tragic emotion, it's wonderful.
Jennifer, you come this morning from Pembrokeshire, which actually is quite a long way from here,
yes,
at least a couple of hours. What made you want to come? How special an experience was it for you to be here?
I just felt the deep need to be here today. I can explain it no other way than a need that will remain with me, the memory will remain with me forever.
Valerie, what about you?
Well, I'm disabled, a little disabled, I say, and I couldn't go to deliver flowers or put them anywhere. I had no method of transport or anything like that. And to come to the cathedral was wonderful when the opportunity turned up and it came through the post and it said you have a place. I was thrilled, absolutely.
What sort of repercussions do you think the Princess of Wales's death will have? Obviously we've heard a great deal about her life, we've all closely followed what happened in London this morning, but what difference do you think it's going to make now?
I think it's going to inspire a lot of people to pull together. I mean, we've seen tremendous national unity over the last week, and I think it's going to carry on.
Thank you all of you very much indeed. In the meantime, back to you, David.
And the hearse is now reaching Luton on the M1, and the same scene, the south going carriageway, all the traffic has been stopped while the cortege heading north passes safely by. And still more flowers being thrown across the motorway as the crowd surges forward. Far more people turning out here than have ever been seen for any royal procession or marriage or indeed any other funeral. People who have a chance only to see a passing car and yet have come in their hundreds to the motorway bridges, to the junctions, just to catch that one brief glimpse. There could be no better tribute from a people than this. Over the brow of the hill and still heading on north. And we'll no doubt catch up with it again later on. But we heard from Wales. Let's now go to Northern Ireland and hear what's been happening today in Belfast with Denis Murray.
And we're here at Belfast City Hall, unprecedented scenes there with the funeral cortege. And something I think unprecedented in Northern Ireland as well, the way in which Diana, Princess of Wales, has united this most divided part of the United Kingdom, united them in grief. I'm joined here at the City Hall, and in fact you can possibly see behind me the flowers, people still leaving flowers this morning, people weeping quietly behind me here just a few minutes ago. I'm joined here now by Nathan Chambers, by Liz McElkearney and by Belfast Lord Mayor Aubin McGuinness. Now Nathan, you were injured in the Enniskillen bombing, the IRA attack on the Poppy Day ceremony in Enniskillen in the late 1980s. You were injured then and you were visited in hospital by the Princess. What did it mean to you? What did she say to you?
Basically the visit was unbelievable. Couldn't believe that the VIP of such an important person was coming to see us, and she was just concerned on how I was getting on. There wasn't much pain, what my injuries were, and she just hoped that I got better soon. And she was just genuinely concerned and very, very loving and compassionate.
And how much of a morale boost was that at what must have been a very difficult time?
Well, up until then you were just thinking of your injuries and how much pain you were in. But when you realised somebody important was coming, you forgot all about that and you were just so excited and so over the moon.
and to all the rest of the patients as well, recovering?
Definitely.